While in his longest ever visit overseas since taking over as Prime Minister, Narendra Modi will travel to the United States this Friday. Defense and security partnerships and economic investment ties, as well as technology transfers, may be on top of his agenda on this highly anticipated visit. Prime Minister Modi will also be delivering his first ever speech at the United Nations General Assembly to discuss this and what this could mean for Indian industry, Indian businesses, and what India is expecting. Adi Godrej, Chairman Godrej Group, joins us on this conversation. Mr. Godrej, many thanks for joining in. Prime Minister Modi has been on a foreign policy overdrive. We saw that with Japan, we saw that with China, and later this month or this week, it's going to be the United States. What's your assessment on what kind of benefit this has had on foreign trade and business?
Well, it's too early to tell, but I think these are very good initiatives the Prime Minister is taking. He's visited the SAARC countries also. He's met with many of the SAARC leaders. He also attended the BRICS summit in Brazil, where he met with all the BRICS leaders. And I think this initiative will yield very strong results because the Indian economy is expected to do very well in the next 5 to 10 years. And it is high time we increase our economic interactions with all the large economies of the world and particularly our neighbors.
Mr. Godrej, you know, Prime Minister Modi heads to the United States for what is perhaps the most important bilateral of all the foreign policy visits and his meeting with President Obama as well. What is Indian industry really expecting from this?
No, I think our economic interactions with the United States need to be taken to quite another plane. I think both mutual investments and trade can increase dramatically. And I think his visit will help achieve that.
Indian companies, Mr. Godrej, have had great relationship with those in the United States, both as a market with technology and people-to-people interaction. What are the areas of cooperation and what do Indian companies seek from the relationship with the United States?
I think it can be larger investments from U.S. companies into the Indian economy. It could be larger investments by Indian companies into the U.S. and dramatically increased levels of trade. It could also mean much larger outsourcing of IT and BPO services from the U.S. to Indian companies, whether they operate in the U.S. or in India.
Right. While we are talking about at a time when the economy is showing signs of recovery, Mr. Godrej, what's your own assessment of recovery in the economy and revival in the investment cycle?
I think the sentiment is extremely strong. The fact that we have a majority government for the first time in 30 years and that this government is very development and growth oriented is a very positive factor. It's created a strong improvement in sentiment. On the ground, improvements are gradual. I expect that during the second half of this year, October to March, we will see a much stronger improvement on the ground. So I expect GDP growth will improve. I expect consumer demand will improve. And I expect also results of companies will improve. The very good news is inflation is coming down. Major commodity prices such as crude oil, vegetable oils are down. And I think that will help a very strong recovery. So I am very confident about the near future. And if we are able to pass the GST at an early date, I think that could add tremendously to economic growth.
With headline inflation, Mr. Godrej, showing signs of easing and oil prices, as you mentioned, also being benign, is there scope for the Reserve Bank of India to be easing interest rates? Do you expect a rate cut later this month?
Well, they ought to, but from what I hear, maybe they won't, because the WPI has come down to less than 4%. So now the real interest rate Indian companies are paying for large investments is over 6%, which is very, very high. So I do hope the Reserve Bank will pay attention to that and bring rates down. I think we need 100 basis points reduction in rates over the next 6 to 8 months.
One last question, sir. Where does this leave the currency? You know, we've seen the currency, in a sense, stabilize, yet has a negative bias. Do you see the currency heading into a volatile territory?
No, the rupee has been reasonably steady. If you look at the rupee over the last few months, it's been reasonably steady. A little bit up and down doesn't matter much. And the rupee is today firmer than what it was a year ago relative to almost all currencies. So that's a good development. I see the rupee continuing to be quite steady. I think the Reserve Bank is managing the rupee extremely well, building up reserves. I think our reserves have gone up by $20-25 billion over the last few months. And I think that is a good development.